Brett, good morning. What can you tell us?
I can tell you now that Cardinal George Pell has been convicted on 5 counts of child sexual abuse. This information can only just be published now because the suppression order was lifted only a few minutes ago. George Pell, Cardinal, third highest ranking member of the Vatican, convicted of 5 counts of child sexual abuse. The 77-year-old was actually tried at the end of last year. It relates to incidents at St Patrick's Cathedral in 1996 when he was Archbishop of Melbourne. Two men alleged that he forced them to perform sexual acts on him when he was at the end of a mass on that particular day. He's been found guilty of 4 counts of performing an indecent act with a child under the age of 16 and 1 count of sexual penetration of a child aged under 16. Now, one of those young men has since passed on. The trial actually only heard from one witness, and that was the other man. The jury deliberated for 2.5 days and came back with a unanimous verdict that George Pell had committed these crimes. We're waiting for him to come out now the suppression order has been lifted. He'll be back in this court tomorrow when the sentencing begins. But Justice Peter Kidd, the trial judge and head of the county court, has indicated he expects George Pell will go to jail.
Brett, we can see behind you there is a huge security presence there. How did Pell react to this news as it came down in court?
Well, he would have known, we knew about the conviction last year. It was simply a matter of when the media could report this. It was only because another separate trial had been dropped that we are allowed to report this information today. I should point out too that Robert Richter QC, who's George Pell's lawyer, has indicated they will be appealing this conviction, arguing that it wasn't made on safe grounds. That will be going to the Court of Appeal sometime in the next couple of days. But concurrently, George Pell will be sentenced. And as I said, the judge has indicated that he will be going to jail. At the moment, George Pell is a free man, but when he goes back into court tomorrow, it's quite likely that during that sentencing process, he will go into custody then. This may be the last time we see George Pell in public for the time being.
The Cardinal has always maintained his innocence, Brett. Are we expecting him to speak at all this morning, knowing that he has a limited time ahead of him before he returns to court tomorrow morning?
He hasn't spoken at all throughout this process, except at the very beginning, before the trial began, to protest his innocence before he came back from Rome for that initial trial. Given now that there is a sentencing about to get underway and an appeal process, I think it's very unlikely he'll be making any public comment. We'll have to wait too to see whether the church has anything to say, whether it's the church here in Melbourne or indeed the Vatican, which has only just held a 3-day conference on the issue of sexual abuse. And just to reiterate, George Pell is the highest member of the Catholic Church anywhere in the world to be convicted of child sexual abuse.
Brett, it's because of that reason we have seen a huge amount of international media attention on this morning, but it has been somewhat limited in how we can report this. What is the attendance like there this morning? Have you got media from the Vatican and from the world descending there on Melbourne?
There's certainly media here from right around the world, and there's actually a lot here last week as well. We thought then we might be able to report this. That was delayed until this process. And yes, there have been people coming here from the States, from Asia, from Europe, because the story carries enormous weight, given Cardinal Pell's status within the church, third highest member of the Vatican. He was effectively the treasurer for the Vatican, appointed by the Pope to oversee the Vatican's finances. But once those charges were laid last year, George Pell was encouraged by the Vatican, by the Pope, to come back here. And it was thought even then it was very unlikely he would ever return to the Vatican, regardless of the outcome of this trial, because the church did not want to have him, with those particular charges having over him, back on that soil.
And Brett, what is security like at the court there this morning? It is a very volatile and emotional issue there. We've seen supporters of child sex abuse victims before arrive at cases like that in the past. Is there a need for security there this morning?
Certainly has been a higher security presence than we normally see at the County Court of Victoria. The way was clear when George Pell arrived by both police and what looked like some private security to lead him into court 3.3 for today's hearing. And even as he leaves too, you can see there's quite a bit of security. And there are survivors here of church sexual abuse. No doubt they'll have quite a bit to say now that this process is over. George Pell was heavily criticised by survivors because of the way he handled the child sex abuse response in Melbourne and beyond that. He was also a strong critic of the Sex Abuse Royal Commission. And in fact, to my memory, the last time he was in the particular courtroom I've just left, 3.3, was when he was giving evidence at the Child Sexual Abuse Royal Commission.
Brett, the Cardinal's health has always been an issue of contention throughout the course of this particular matter. It's that he fought coming back from the Vatican because they said he wasn't well enough. He is back in Australia now and he's been part of this process. But how has he seemed in terms of his health?
He's been very frail. He did need to have two knee operations, I understand. And you'll see in a lot of footage that we can only reveal now, in the times he's gone in and out of court over the past few months, he's been on crutches, looking very much his 77 years, quite stooped. George Pell had been a physically overbearing man, but he's been aged considerably by the knee injuries, although he is walking more freely these days. And as I said earlier, we've heard nothing from him during this process, which is only what you'd expect from someone on such serious charges.
Well, Brett, let's just recap then on the sentence that, or the verdict that's been given this morning, and where to from here now, because it'll be back in court tomorrow morning.
Sure. As I said, George Pell convicted of five child sexual abuse charges, four counts of performing an indecent act with a child under the age of 16, one count of sexual penetration of a child aged under 16. All five charges, the jury, after deliberating for 2.5 days, unanimously found him guilty. The next step in the process, George Pell back here tomorrow before the same judge, where the plea hearing will begin on what sentence is appropriate. But the judge has indicated all along that guilty verdict means jail time.
And any indication at this stage of whether an appeal may be lodged?
Yes, George Pell's lawyer, Robert Richter QC, a very prominent barrister in Melbourne, has already indicated that they will be appealing this verdict. They say that they don't believe that there was good grounds for the verdict to be reached. That'll be taken over by the Court of Appeal, literally across the road from where I'm standing. Probably those papers will be lodged straight away. When that will be heard may take some time. It's quite possible the whole sentencing process will be finished by the time that the appeal process is over. But George Pell is a man who almost needs no introduction. Ever since he came to public life and came to prominence as Archbishop of Melbourne, he's a man who's caught a lot of attention and had a lot of critics as well.